folks. Back in the building now. I want to talk about a topic that's kind of really ingrained in our people. It's that jealousy and envy shit that's going on. Like, I found out that people are really mad because people are making bucks off of YouTube. And they're like, you're making money off of YouTube. Yeah? What is that? A lot of people are mad at other folks are making a buck. Now, I have a problem with the way you make your buck on YouTube. Like, if it's like just exploitation, cool, I have a problem with that. But I don't have a problem overall with people making the money. You gotta pay bills somehow. And the bad part about it is people who can't make money or don't know how to make money are usually the fucking ones that are saying this. Now, I'll probably get people saying, I know how to make money. Then what the fuck you bitching for? Everybody who I know that knows how to make money isn't worried about people who make money because they make their own. And we sure as fuck ain't worried about people who don't know how to make money and want to ride coattails. But you got these bitches on YouTube, and these are, and then I'm only talking to you if it relates to you. Don't, if it doesn't relate to you, don't get offended. And I don't want to have all these fucking people in my email. So you talk, da, da, da. It only if it relates to you, I'm talking about you. I get all these bitches on my fucking thing. And I do it all the time. I do this, like, type my name in the search, whatever. And there's, I mean, if you gonna make a video about me or about a reply, that's cool. But when you got a video that has nothing to do with me, and you got my name in there, I got a problem with that shit. Like, I ain't gonna go up to you and, like, get your channel taken down because I'm not doing that. It's, to me, that's just kid shit. It's third grade shit. But I do know that you ain't about shit. Because, like I said, if you were about shit, you'd be on your own. You wouldn't need to ride off of my coattails, which I'm shocked that people will ride my coattails to begin with, to get views. Like, people say, well, how do you get views? I'm going to talk a little bit about it here. And once I get to a certain point on my views, I'm gonna tell you the rest. First of all, I talk about topics that can relate to anybody. Second of all, the studio that I'm on now, and if you go to Social Blade, type in Lower Entertainment, it'll show you my studio that I'm on now. They're backing me. Matter of fact, I'll tell you right now, it's a quiz group. Quiz group out of Moscow. The Soviet Union. I'm Comrade Womack. That's what my name is. And what happened was, it's no secret. I was on RPM. And the reason I left RPM, I'm going to be straight up honest with you. Unless you're a big dude, it ain't happening. Like, I was big, but what the point was, they were trying to get me. I was in there with fucking schmucks. You know, like, if you saw the thing, I was getting views, I was doing this, I was doing that. When RPM, they wanted you to do this and jump through hoops. I'm like, no, fuck that. So what I did is I blew my contract in my year. I played the soldier. You know, I played the company role, kept my head down, just, you know, made what I made on the side. Then it's time for my contract to come up. I said, well, I'd like to get out of my contract. You know, I did all the proper procedures. And so I said to myself, I'm going to sit back and see what comes of me. Now, the funny part about it is on my other channel, I had RPM a representative or an affiliate, whatever they're called, come to me and ask about joining RPM. I said, I don't want to be on RPM. Because RPM doesn't do anything for you. What they do is they sit there and watch you grow your channel. So I was sitting there and I was taking offers, and I talked to my family first and for all this. I said, I'm going to take offers and see what's going to happen. All of a sudden I seen a quiz group, and I seen, you know, we'd be interested in you joining our network. How about, you know, signing up for us? And I saw the information, and I said, quiz group. Never heard of quiz group. So I looked them up. Look them up on Google Chrome, because that'll be the easy translation. Don't have to touch the English or Russian thing. Found out they were in Moscow. And after doing a week of research, I found out that I did everything. I found out that would be my best interest. So we just got, after I did a week of research, then we did a week of negotiations. And after my week of negotiations, finally we signed the contract and saw my member news group. Well, quiz group, my fault. We look at quiz group and it opens open doors for me. I've opened doors for them. So me, it was a no-lose situation. Now, I'm going to have haters and other people saying, well, you're on YouTube to make money. When I wasn't making money, I was talking about the same thing. Now, I'm not making all that much like you people think. I'm still talking about the same thing. My platform hasn't changed. What I'm telling you about hasn't changed. I haven't changed. The only thing now is I get a couple dollars. My fault. I got a couple euros come my way. Now, that being said, if people watch my videos, you would take what I'm doing and learn from that. Don't straight fucking copy. Take from my videos and learn from what I'm doing. Craft it your way. First, we got to be a kind of a news junkie. Growing up, I was into sports and the news. I was a big news junkie. Sometimes whenever everybody was outside playing football, this, that, and the fifth, I'd be sitting there reading the paper, watching TV. My parents were like, hey, don't get outside. No, I was that type of kid. But I'm generally interested in a lot of shit. My interest peaks on a lot of shit. I don't have to talk, like, even though some of these YouTube channels, they talk about one specific thing. But I don't. I can open multiple channels. If I was about that, I would open multiple channels and talk about each other topic. But I'm not. Look, man. Any more than four channels, you gotta be a fucking crazy bastard to have fucking any more than like four or five channels. Unless that's your job and it's in your contract and you're required to do that. If you're making fucking hundreds of channels for free, you're fucking crazy and you're fucking stupid, in my opinion. That's just me talking. It's probably a lot of you agree with me, but you won't put it down, but I can take the heat. But now people are mad. Well, you're making money. Motherfucker, I gotta eat. I got kids. I got car payments to make. I got fucking mistresses to entertain. I got fucking wives and wife-in-laws, and I got fucking side pieces and dimes I gotta take care of. How do you think they the good looks gonna go so far? So, at the end of the day, unless I've changed, you got no bitch. You can just sit back and learn what I did and do it to you. Don't be like some of your YouTubers on here and do exactly what I'm doing. Like, copying my lingo. Some of them were like, and my lingo isn't like the newest lingo. I'm using some lingo that you may not have heard of in a while. But now, some of your favorite YouTubers, I've become their favorite YouTuber. Because I'm following a lot of styles on here. So, Daddy's back. Daddy got, Papa's the Rolling Stone. I'm getting that cash. My fault, I'm getting them euros. So, I'm out of here. Peace.
There. That's it. That's him.